Hello, boys and girls, and children of all ages. This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. In this story, each character is represented by his own musical theme, played by special instruments in the orchestra. Let's meet the bird, whose music is played by the flute. The duck is played by the oboe. And Peter's cat, by the clarinet. Oh, and Peter's grandfather is played by the big bassoon. And our villain, the wolf, is represented by French horns, three of them. Sound of the hunter's guns, the kettle drums. Peter's music is played by all the strings. After all, he's the hero of our story. Let's begin. A long time ago, a boy named Peter lived with his grandfather in a small cottage with a garden surrounded by a high stone wall. Outside the wall was a beautiful meadow with a tiny pond and a very, very tall tree. Beyond the lovely meadow was a deep, dark forest. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and strolled out into the green meadow. Thank you. A friend of his was already there, perched on the branch of a tree. That's right, it was his friend the bird. Hello, chirped the bird, what a beautiful day. All is quiet, all is quiet, all is quiet, all is quiet. Soon a duck came waddling by. Oh, she was so glad that Peter had forgotten to close the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Saw the duck, he flew right down to the grass, settling comfortably next to the duck. He shrugged his shoulders. What kind of a bird are you if you can't fly? Said the little bird to the duck. What kind of a bird are you if you can't swim? Said the duck to the bird, as he dived into the pond. Argued the duck swimming in the pond and the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling along the grass. The cat thought, while the bird is busy arguing, I'll just grab him. Quietly and carefully, without making a sound, the cat crept toward the little bird on her velvet paws. looked out like pity, and the bird flew immediately into the tree. While the duck clapped angrily at the cat, from the middle of the pond, the cat crawled around and around the tree, and she thought, is it worth climbing to the top of the tree? I mean, by the time I get there, the bird will have flown away. Sensible cat. Before long, Grandfather came out of the house. Oh, he was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow. He said the meadow is a dangerous place. What if the wolf should come out of the forest? What would you do then? What would you do then? Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words. It seems that brave boys like Peter are not afraid of wolves. Peter's grandfather was determined. He took Peter by the hand, led him home, and locked the gate. Sooner had Peter and his grandfather gone inside when a big gray wolf came out of the forest. In a flash, the cat sprang into the tree. The duck quacked and quacked. Well, in her excitement, she ended up out of the pond onto the grass. No matter how hard she tried to run, the duck couldn't escape the wolf. The wolf came nearer and nearer and nearer, catching up with her. And then he caught her. And then, oh, he swallowed her down with one single gulp. Gulp. So now, this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch up in the tree. The bird sitting on another. Oh, not too close to the cat. Was pacing around and around the tree, looking up at them both with very greedy eyes. In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate and watched all that was going on. Suddenly, Peter got an idea. He ran home, grabbed a strong rope, and climbed the high stone wall. From the top of the wall, Peter could reach one of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was still walking. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter climbed onto the tree. Now listen carefully, Peter whispered to the bird. Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Oh, and make sure he doesn't catch you. The bird almost touched the wolf's nose with his wings while the wolf snapped furiously at him from this side and that. How that bird annoyed that wolf, and oh, how that wolf wanted to catch that bird. But the bird was much too clever for the wolf, and the wolf, the greedy wolf, just couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, back in the tree, Peter took the rope and made a lasso, and letting it down very, very carefully, down, down, down. Caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get free, trying to get loose. Peter, who was very clever, tied the other end of the rope to the tree. So, the more the wolf jumped, the tighter the rope got around his tail. Just then, the hunters came out of the woods. They were following the wolf's trail, and they were shooting their guns as they approached. Thank you. No, no, don't shoot, said Peter. Bertie and I have caught the wolf. All we need you to do is help us get him to the zoo. Just imagine the triumphant procession. Peter proudly marching in front. Hunters leading the wolf. Session. Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather shaking his head, thinking, oh, what if Peter had not caught the wolf? What then? Above them flew the little bird, chirping away happily. Aren't we smart, Peter and I? Look what we've caught, he said proudly. And if you listen very carefully, you can hear the duck quacking inside the wolf's belly. Yes? Yes, that's the duck, all right. Because the wolf, in his hurry, had swallowed her. alive. And that's the story of Peter and the Wolf.